WWE Network presents WWE Survivor Series Best of the Best Kickoff.
WWE Universe, there is a lot to unpack tonight as we get you set for one of the biggest nights each and every year in WWE. Tonight we'll present battles among champions, battles among brands, and in some cases, possibly even battles among those who should be considered allies. And tonight we determine the best of the best. And with that, we welcome all of you in to the Survivor Series kickoff show. How you doing, everybody?
Good.
Thanks for being here with us. My name's Charlie Caruso, and we've got an all-star cast joining us on the panel tonight. The best of the best, if you will, gentlemen. You see what I did there?
Yes.
All right, let's get to some introductions. Over here we have WWE Hall of Famer Jerry the King Lawler.
Well, thank you, Charlie. It's great to be here. I've been in WWE a long time, and I've witnessed a lot of momentous moments, but tonight may turn out to be the biggest. I'm excited.
I would love to see that. All right, next we have two-time WWE Hall of Famer Booker T.
Thank you very much. Guys, step on in. It's the kickoff show. Get your champagne wishes and caviar dream.
Ooh, do we get some of that?
Oh, yes.
Where's our caviar?
I got you covered.
Over here we have Hall of Fame-elect JBL.
It is great to be here. I agree with King. It's a terrific night. We're getting the final farewell to, in my opinion, the greatest of all time, The Undertaker.
Oh.
Absolutely. And finally, Hot 97 and ESPN's very own Peter Rosenberg.
I'm just honored, honestly, to be here with you guys tonight for 30 years of The Undertaker saying farewell. This is a fan's dream come true. I just can't believe I'm here.
I like the shirt.
Oh, hey now, vintage,
there you go.
Vintage Undertaker, baby. And you know I had to.
We can't believe you're here either.
No Hall of Fame bids for this one, unfortunately.
No.
Gentlemen, we have some Survivor Series history on this very panel, some of which has collided in the past. I'm not going to.
We've had a little tussle or two.
There are a couple tussles here and there.
One of the kings, there, King Booker and I.
Yeah, absolutely.
The initiation of the Elimination Chamber. Yeah, definitely. It was a great time.
Yeah, well, you know, tonight really is about determining the best of the best. But as you all know, there's only one place to watch the show. It is the best place to watch the show, and that is on the WWE Network. So right now, everybody, you have one job. Go to WWENetwork.com and subscribe because Survivor Series is going to be free with that subscription.
How much was that?
Oh, you tell me.
$3.99, y'all.
We love to hear it. Also included, when you subscribe, you will get NXT TakeOver on December 6th. Also, next month's pay-per-view, TLC, included in that subscription. But, Peter, we have a lot to talk about tonight, so let's get it going.
Well, let's get it started with the money. There's a lot to talk about when it comes to Survivor Series, but I'll tell you what, it gets no bigger than this right here. Champion versus champion. Drew McIntyre has the title again, and he's taking on the big dog, Roman Reigns. Of course, he's got his special counsel, Paul Heyman, at ringside.
And tonight, one team unified goes against a team in complete disarray when the ladies of SmackDown take on the women of Raw in the traditional 5-on-5 Survivor Series elimination match.
And hold on one second, Charlie. This is special. Yes. A dual-branded battle royal. And guess what, guys? It's happening right here on the Survivor Series kickoff show.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, can't wait for that one. United States champion Bobby Lashley has bulldozed his way through the Raw roster. But can he do the same tonight when he faces the antagonizing Intercontinental Champion representing SmackDown, Sami Zayn?
And you know the ladies weren't the only ones who could get in on that traditional Survivor Series action. We also have a 5-on-5 men's Survivor Series elimination match, Team Raw versus Team SmackDown.
And tonight we will find out what happens when the power of positivity clashes with all the smoke. It's the Raw Tag Team Champions, The New Day, up against the SmackDown Champion Street Profits to determine the best of the best.
And guess what? I am excited to see these ladies do it again. This match could steal the show. The Raw Women's Champion versus the SmackDown Women's Champion. You have Asuka and Sasha Banks.
And talk about stealing the show. Not only will tonight feature epic battles between the biggest competitors from both brands, but Survivor Series will also feature the final farewell from one of the biggest legends in the business, The Undertaker. That being on the 30th anniversary of his WWE debut.
From Death Valley, I give you The Undertaker.
We got this ball,
everything, there were constants here, and he was a constant. His legacy is that there'll never be another.
He was able to take that character and morphed it in order to keep this dead man alive.
The longevity, and to get such reaction, it was just magic.
We're lucky to be able to have seen him perform.
The bar for respect for WWE is The Undertaker. Our lasting impression of The Undertaker is our never-ending, ass-kicking, undead phenomenon.
The Undertaker has won the respect from all of the fans, and the adulation that he gets is well-deserved from around the world.
To ride the edge of a lightning bolt for 30 years, he's had, hands down, one of the absolute best careers in the history of the business.
Pretty incredible. Exactly 30 years ago, The Undertaker debuted at this very pay-per-view event, Survivor Series, and really he transcended the business. I think it would be hard to find someone, even a non-WWE fan, who has not heard of The Undertaker. I mean, he is truly a pop culture icon, I would say, at this point, and absolutely one of the legends of our business. So with that, I'd like to go around the table and really just hear what tonight means for each of you, and also feel free to share your favorite memory as it pertains to The Undertaker. Jerry.
You want to start with me? Sure. Well, it's good that you start with me because I started with The Undertaker even more than 30 years ago when he debuted down in Memphis, Tennessee as Mean Mark, the Master of Pain. So I have a lot of memories of him. And then, unfortunately, coming into the WWE, I had the unfortunate experience to face The Undertaker in a casket match.
How'd that go for you?
Those not well. I think you can ask any of his opponents how right. the casket match goes. Not well. But, yeah, that's why tonight is called the best of the best, because that's I can't think of a better way to describe The Undertaker than the best of
yeah,
the best.
Definitely. You know, for me, when I came to WWE in early 2000s, he was the guy that pretty much, you know, pulled me in. Especially at WrestleMania, my first WrestleMania, Taker said, man, just take it in, kid. And that meant so much for me as a new guy being a part of the company. He was a leader. He was that general that set everybody on track and made sure everybody did a great job, as well as what I'm proud of most. Where are you from? What state?
The great state of Texas.
And, I'm from Texas, and I know The Undertaker's from Texas by way of Death Valley. He's Texas' greatest representative in this business. Definitely, it's going to be a great night.
Yeah, I used to be 7 foot tall, and after all the tombstones, I'm now 6'6". So I'm taking a bunch of them. Like, I don't think in the history of sport or entertainment there's anybody who's had a run like The Undertaker clearly on top. I mean, all due respect to guys I admire a lot with Shawn and Hogan, San Martino, Stone Cold, The Rock. He is, in my opinion, the longevity and being on top for 30 straight years is setting that standard, the greatest of all time.
And
constant.
And you said it, JBL. I mean, when you saw that package, the first voice you hear is Gorilla Monsoon. He goes all the way back to Gorilla Monsoon and bridges the gap all the way up to John Cena and Roman Reigns and where we are today, to classic matches with you guys in the mid-2000s.
Yeah.
Every single era. And one other thing I love about the dead man, The Rock, Hogan, Austin, they're superstars for everyone. The Undertaker, while, Charlie, he is a crossover star, he's ours. He's a wrestling fan's wrestler, you know? He really, really is. He's truly one of a kind.
Absolutely. I mean, he has built a legacy like no other. And, you know, to transition from that, it's a really hard topic to transition from because he is so legendary. But there are two men in WWE who are building legacies of their own. They have a match tonight. It would be Drew McIntyre and Roman Reigns. So with that, let's send things back to Kayla Braxton, who's standing by with Paul Heyman. Hey, Kayla.
Paul, last night on Talking Smack, you emotionally and quite impulsively accused WWE of false advertising for promoting Drew McIntyre versus Roman Reigns as a champion versus champion match. You brazenly dubbed the match a champion versus title holder match, stating that Drew McIntyre was merely a title holder. And I would like to give you the opportunity to retract that statement.
Are you flirting with me? Is that like some sort of assertiveness? And no, I don't wish to retract my statement. I insist on doubling down on it. Roman Reigns is the champion. T-H-E-E. SmackDown, Raw, NXT, WWE, all of sports entertainment. Drew McIntyre? That's a title holder. He's a prop. He's a stand-in. Oh, we need a guy with a title to take a picture with this executive, with this sponsor. Roman Reigns is too busy for that. Send in Drew McIntyre. He's a temporary placeholder in the history books for Raw. Drew McIntyre is a babysitter for a belt. Roman Reigns makes the championship. He brings to the Universal Championship honor, prestige, dignity, history, lineage, and will leave behind a legacy that no other man can catch. Tonight, the winner of the match is your reigning, defending, undisputed WWE Universal Heavyweight Champion, Roman Reigns.
How could you think anybody would flirt with him?
Yeah, that made me laugh.
You guys are pals, aren't you, King? You guys have always got along well.
Yes, yes, yes.
Guys, I want to know what you think about his comments, though, that Roman Reigns is the champion while Drew McIntyre is merely just a title holder. Booker?
You know, title holder, you know, what he's talking about is for us sending, you know, sending men there to do the cleanup work, you know, signing autographs, you know, doing that kind of work. It takes a champion to do that. I look at a guy like John Cena. John Cena was a guy that did the work in the ring as well as the work out of the ring. And that's the kind of guy that Drew McIntyre actually wanted to be. That's the kind of champion that Drew McIntyre actually is. So, I disagree with Paul Heyman. And that's, you know, I don't do that too often.
Does anyone agree with Paul Heyman here?
Well, you can make the argument that Roman Reigns is the guy, always is the guy, and any other champion is not quite Roman Reigns. But the truth is, at some point, we better start to respect Drew McIntyre. I mean, Booker, we've sat here and bet against Drew McIntyre many times against Randy Orton. Are we going to make that mistake again?
Yeah, it's real simple. You want to get respect, he beats Roman Reigns tonight. It's that simple. Look, I don't agree necessarily with what Paul Heyman said, but he certainly has a right to say it. And I'm not sure he even buys it. I'm just sure he thinks that it's his guy, and he's putting his guy over as he best he can as an advocate. And if Drew doesn't like it, Drew beats Roman Reigns tonight.
Good point. Can I just
this
say
is a real heavyweight match.
Can I just say this? Drew McIntyre is like 6'5". He's over 260 pounds. You know, if anybody can say that they're the guy who's willing to go out there and beat the guy, it's Drew McIntyre.
All right. Well, we definitely are going to look more into this match coming up later on the kickoff show. Right now, I want to shift our focus to the women's match happening between the SmackDown Women's Champion, Sasha Banks, Raw Women's Champion, Asuka. A match that we all are waiting to see what's going to happen because this rivalry has been going on since this summer.
This is the Credit One Bank One to watch. Visit GoCreditOne.com. Life ever rewarded.
Guys, this is what happened last week on Raw right here. And you look at Shayna Baszler right there just lowering the boom on Mandy Rose. You can see Mandy's in a lot of pain.
I mean, if Shayna...
And it just continues right here. You see, Mandy Rose is still just in a place of hurt. This right here, guys, it seems like a rerun over and over and over. Lana just taking the pain.
It's like Groundhog Day for her.
Okay, so obviously now we're talking about the women's five-on-five match, not Asuka versus Sasha Banks. We will talk about that a little bit later. So let's focus in on this match right here. There seems to be a lot of dissent on the side of the Raw women's team. Do you think that these five women are going to be able to coexist long enough to even have a chance to get a win against SmackDown? JBL?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, I've been in a lot of Survivor Series matches. You don't always lock the people on your side,
that's
but you're a
right
team
there.
And you're in a competition, and you forget all about that. Afterwards, you're not going out to drinks together. You're not going to have coffee together. But when that match is on, you want to win. And so I don't think any of that matters in this.
One night only. That's the way I look at it. I mean, we got to go out here for one common cause, and that's to get a win first and foremost. But normally when you get a win, the check is bigger.
Right. Well, and Book, you were a part of an all-time Survivor Series. That was an amazing moment. But, like, it was such a random array of superstars, ECW, WCW, WWE, all coming together. But you found a way to make it work and at least compete.
Yeah. But, before I let you talk to our King, still everybody is going to be out for themselves, man. At a time like that, you know, everybody's looking to get their little piece of the action, their champagne wishes and caviar dreams. So don't think I was thinking too much about them other guys.
Yeah, you never know. You know, I was part of a Survivor Series team. I was a captain of a team.
I remember
that
team.
Went through and defeated the entire other team without losing one member. So
wasn't that the collective clown show that you were against?
It was you against Doink and Dink.
Okay, they were clowns or us, but
they all didn't add up to one person.
That doesn't matter.
They stood all each other's shoulders.
Hey, come on, wait a minute. Give them a little props, okay?
A little prop.
Just give them a
see
little
what
bit
you
of
did there. Give them a little prop.
Well, anyway, that's what they need to try to do. They got to stay on the same page tonight, and if the Raw women can do that, they will win.
Well, they need to stay on the same page. In fact, we just now found out who the final members of Team Raw actually were, because obviously we saw from the B-roll from this past Monday there were two injuries, two replacements coming in, and on the SmackDown side, they just rounded out their team as well, Natalya making up the fifth and final spot. So Team SmackDown is set for competition tonight.
Hey, you're talking about the best of the best right here. You're talking about Natalya going out here getting that final spot, and the beat Tamina. That's big ups.
Oh, she was happy.
She's happy.
Very happy.
You know, these are the opportunities that Natalya always craves, so you know that she's ready for anything that comes her way. And
what do we have here?
Women's team.
Hello.
Bianca Belair, how you doing?
I am doing great.
You look great tonight.
Thank you so much.
Rocking the blue.
What an upgrade from Peter Rosenberg being here. Good grief. Did we win with that deal? Holy cow. Talk about a dime for a dollar.
So how are you feeling heading into tonight? How are you feeling not about, you know, what you're going to bring to the table, but the entire women's team on the blue brand?
Listen, I am so excited tonight. I am so excited about Survivor Series. I'm ready to get in there and show everyone why I call myself the EST of WWE, why I'm the strongest and the fastest and the roughest and the toughest, the quickest and the greatest and the best.
All of that.
And I'm excited to get in there with my teammates, Ruby and Liv and Natty. She finally qualified for the team. And Bayley, she's feeling herself a little bit, so she named herself the captain. But I'm just excited to get in there and show that we're the best of the best tonight.
Me and Jim, we were just talking a second ago. Is this just a one-night thing? Are you looking to come up and really make your...
Hey, guys. It's so good to see you. You look beautiful.
Oh, Natalya.
What are you doing out here, man?
How's it going?
Hey, a heart at Survivor Series. That's very appropriate.
Very, very appropriate, indeed. No, it's so good to see everybody. And, you know, speaking about Bayley.
We're just talking to the captain of the team right here.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
She was there.
Bianca's not the captain. Bayley's not the captain. I mean, Bayley, I feel for her because she's trying to find her relevance. And we all feel for her. She has a great heart. She's a great girl.
I mean, somebody got to be the leader on that team, though, right?
I mean, I think everybody is looking at me since I'm the best of all time.
First of all, if anybody's going to be the leader, it's going to be the first person that qualified for Team SmackDown, which is Bianca Belair, the EST of WWE.
I'm not going to bring up politics, but there was a lot of reasons why I didn't qualify before you, and
Natty, are you saying you the boss of this team?
Well, I think everybody knows with the experience I bring. I don't think anybody knows, actually, that I've survived the most Survivor Series of any woman in WWE history. I've had the most matches of any woman in WWE history. I've had the most wins of any woman in WWE history. And I think that really makes me not only the leader, but the best of all time.
Oh, okay. The boat. It's called the boat, right?
Yes. Natty, you got that right.
Natty, you call yourself the boat, right? So what's the most famous boat that you know?
The Titanic.
Exactly. Oh. And what happened to the Titanic?
Okay, Debbie Downer. Okay, Debbie Downer.
Listen,
the Titanic, Debbie Downer, enough from you. The Titanic made a ton of money. And Leonardo DiCaprio was really cute.
Oh, he was.
So we're talking about the movie. I'm not going to shoot right now. We got to focus on tonight. Just make sure you don't sink the team tonight.
Sink the team,
which I know you won't because you're the boat,
honey bunny, you better watch and learn.
You're the boat.
I'm the best of all time. It goes like this, right?
Of all time. Oh, girl.
That's what we call a remix.
Oh, yeah, baby.
So make sure
it's not
that
a cute name.
I like it. That's actually good. It's
I'm sailing.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
But make sure that you don't think us tonight.
Okay, Miss
Well,
Thames.
Ladies, I mean, this is, look, we want to keep it cordial, right? I mean, you have a big match tonight.
Unlike Raw, we are all on the same page.
Okay.
We're just making sure.
No, we don't have to keep it cordial. If y'all want to fight, y'all can.
Look, then you're just like Team Raw. I don't know.
Yes, we are. You need to behave yourself.
Oh, I will.
So, Natty, you're saying if you were the Titanic, the iceberg would have sunk.
Well, I'm not talking about icebergs. I'm talking about winning this match tonight. And on that note, King, I got to go.
Bye.
Bye.
We're not...
This has been the Credit One Bank One to Watch. Visit GoCreditOne.com. Life ever rewarded.
All right. We're going to move on from that one.
All right.
He's moved back.
Hey, you missed me?
What's going on, man?
Did you miss him, JBL?
I had a headset on. I could hear everything you said.
we love you, brother.
No, we don't.
Okay, gentlemen, there is a tag team championship match tonight. We got the Raw Tag Team Champs versus SmackDown Tag Team Champs.
Get it out.
Look, experience here. New Day, they win in that department. Is that going to make any difference here tonight at Survivor Series? Peter, you want to take this one?
Well, I just think it's a huge moment for the Street Profits. I actually saw them earlier and said, I think you guys have an opportunity to steal the show. A lot of people are excited about what the Street Profits are doing. But if you're really going to make a name, and they've had a big year for sure, you got to beat a legendary tag team. I would argue the best tag team of the last decade, the New Day. So it's a huge opportunity for the Street Profits to really show just how good 2020 has been for them.
But if you're the best tag team of the last decade, that there is a reason that you say that they are, because they are, and they have been the cream of the crop. And I just can't see the Street Profits beating them. But if they do, like you say, massive step for the guys.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and I think it's a massive step, maybe stepping over the line to say that the Street Profits might steal the show tonight. I don't think that's going to happen. I think, like you said, Charlie, experience is going to play a great big factor in this match, and this experience goes to New Day.
Look, I look at it like this. You know, being a former tag team champion myself with four different partners, you know, on all continents. I look at Street Profits, and I say, man, these guys got all the tools to be the, you know, perhaps the greatest tag team since Harlem Heat, but they're going to have to find another gear. I'm serious. They're gonna have to
Easy,
switch.
Shaq.
They're going to have to switch gears, and they're going to have to go out here, no plan, no jiving, just business. They can't look at the New Day as friends or anything like that. They got to go out here and look at these guys and say, man, I'm here to take what you got, and that is that spot. And with that spot comes money. With that money comes prestige. With that prestige comes power. That's what they got to go out there and do tonight. Joe, I'll see you over there.
Well, I mean, you say they're trying to, they need to steal that spot. It is exactly what they're trying to do. Obviously, they tried to sway Big E into feeding them whatever secrets they could to get a little bit more perspective and maybe form a little bit of a better strategy against the New Day.
Big E, he's there for a reason. He's definitely that third eye. You can't trust anybody. Like I say, the Street Profits got to go out tonight and serve business. They got to bring what they call it, the the smoke there it
and
is.
And Booker, I agree with you. They're trying to get Big E to give you some secrets on that. It's like trying to get your brother Stevie Ray to give you a secret.
That's true.
Get Ron Simmons to give one on me. It's just not simply going to happen. They should have known better than that. And the Street Profits, I agree with you. They need to quit worrying about all the trappings. They need to quit worrying about it being entertaining. And they need to win in that ring.
Bottom line.
That is legacy
Bottom
and that
line.
Is history.
I mean, look at me. How many importance I just said it. How many tag team championships? You got to go. At the end of the day, it's about the legacy that you leave in the business. I'm just saying.
All right, gentlemen. Well, we are counting down the minutes until Survivor Series. We have some legends in the house this evening. Rikishi here, not only probably here for the Undertaker's final farewell, but also talking a little strategy with Jey Uso, who's getting ready for that 5-on-5 Survivor Series match. A lot going on here at the Thunderdome.
Yeah.
You know, I say let's switch over to Bobby Lashley and Sami Zayn. Let's switch those gears.
Switch gears.
Gentlemen, what are your thoughts as we approach this match here tonight? United States champion versus Intercontinental champion, Raw versus SmackDown, Bobby Lashley versus Sami Zayn. Book.
You know, this is Bobby Lashley getting a chip in the game. Right now he's champion, but to become double champion is something that we all wish to become. You know, just like when I came over from WCW, I was the United States. I brought that championship here. I was the United States champion. And
the this is the Booker T show tonight. I'm here for it.
I'm just saying. And Bobby, he's been going against, you know, no disrespect or anything, but a lot of guys that's not up to his caliber.
Agreed.
Bobby Lashley need to step up to the next year and start taking these guys out one by one until he become heavyweight champion universal. He got to put himself in the game, and it starts tonight.
Sami Zayn's a great place to start.
Excuse me.
Oh, what's up, Sammy? How
Booker,
you doing, dog?
I hate to interrupt you. I mean, a real star-studded lineup here. Real stars. Well,
yeah.
One of these things is not like the other, right, fellas?
Beautiful title there.
I was about to say something nice about
that's
you.
It's okay. I just have to address the elephant in the room. And Booker's going on and on and on about how great Bobby Lashley is. I don't ask for much. Booker, I really don't. Jerry, I don't ask for a lot. I'm a man of principle. I'm a man of conviction. I don't need the accolades. I don't need everyone to tell me how great I am. All I want is a little respect. The respect that I deserve.
Well, I respect you. I respect you. I put you in my Fave Five last week.
I actually did see that.
At the top.
I did, and I appreciate that.
I said, if I had 10 Sami Zayns, man, this company would be over the moon. I like everything you do. I was just giving it my opinion.
And I put you in my MySpace top eight last week. You're there.
Why did I know that was coming from you?
And, Sammy, listen, I listened very intently about what you said about your title, the Intercontinental title, as opposed to Bobby Lashley's United States title.
Tell us
about that. Why is that so much more prestigious?
Because this championship represents every country on every continent on this great planet. Whereas Bobby Lashley's United States championship represents one country, which I'm not even going to get into because it's too easy. Quite frankly, a little depressing. So I'm not even going to touch that.
Go there,
the
man.
I don't need to.
You have something against the United States?
Anywho.
Is that a yes?
The point is, I represent the people, not the things that the United States represents.
Just asking the United
States, nothing about the United States Championship represents the will of the people. This has always been a championship that's been respected in every country because there is a work ethic that comes with this championship that is respected by the working class all over the world. You go to Germany, you go to South Africa,
Sammy, you go to Somalia.
We got to take a break.
You're
cutting me off.
No, I'm not cutting you off, but
this is what I mean.
This is the lack of respect
that I'm talking about. I will earn my respect tonight when I defeat Bobby Lashley. Just you watch.
Thank you.
Ouch. Thanks, Booker, you hit him with the "we got to take a break."
We do, though.
We're going
to a break right now. Everybody stay with us.
Hyundai and WWE share in a united cause that celebrates putting people first. We are mutually driven to seek better, to put smiles on faces.
Oh, Tyler!
To do better day in and day out.
Hyundai and I want to recognize the night weekend shift nurses, and so we would like to deliver food to your unit.
So Hyundai and WWE are joining forces this year to learn what drives, what inspires, and what motivates people to seek better, to want better, to need better.
Congratulations to Alex and Jordan, this year's National Youth Ambassadors.
behalf of myself and every WWE superstar, keep inspiring because you really are making such a positive difference.
Look for us on the road and in your community, because together we are stronger and we are better. Drive for better.
All right, one of the matches we're all looking forward to, that men's Survivor Series elimination match. Just for a little recap for everybody, Team SmackDown consisting of Seth Rollins, King Corbin, Kevin Owens, Jey Uso, and Otis. Then we have Team Raw, Braun Strowman, Keith Lee, Sheamus, Riddle, and of course the self-proclaimed captain, AJ Styles. I want to talk about this whole captain thing because it seems to be ruffling some feathers, I would say on both sides of WWE. What do you think? Is AJ Styles the captain, or is somebody else better suited for that?
Hey.
I mean,
what's up, folks?
How you doing,
bro? Trizzle.
What's up, dog?
How you doing, dude?
What's up, dog?
What you doing here, man?
This is not Raw Talk.
What you doing here?
No, check it out. See, WWE, what's up, Rosenberg?
Hey.
They celebrating the 30th anniversary of a WWE superstar.
That's right.
Yeah, we know
more,
that.
More than a superstar.
That's what we're here for.
This superstar right here is a no-doubt Hall of Famer.
Oh, yeah, easy. No doubt.
Okay, you know what? I took it upon myself, me, to make my own tribute to this phenom.
Oh, that was nice.
Roll the tape.
What? He brought tape?
Roll the tape.
I did.
Wow.
You did this yourself?
Yeah, how did you do that?
That's dope. But
I think that egg is ready to blow.
Oh, what?
What in the world is this? A gobbledygook. Ha! Don't tell me you're the gobbledygooker.
A superstar of superstars. The phenom. You know what I'm saying?
He's athletic.
The phenom.
I'm very athletic. You know what I'm saying?
I will. That was athletic.
It was.
Hall of Fame is written all over.
Wait. Truth.
Okay.
Truth, you got to understand, this is the 30th anniversary of The Undertaker. Not the gobbledygooker.
It was the same. It was the same night in 1990. It was the same night. We're celebrating the Undertaker.
Yeah.
One's undead. One was dead on arrival.
Yeah.
Well, you guys and gals have to tell him that y'all sales.
Tell who?
Undertaker. Come here, Google.
Oh no!
Hey, check this out. Look.
It's him. That's
when
really
this guy
the
debuted.
Hey.
When this guy debuted, I almost dropped the action figure
what up, Gook?
Of my childhood hero, John Cena.
Oh, you had a John Cena action figure back in the early 90s.
Yeah, but you couldn't see it.
Did you just say, what's up,
Gook?
Hey, look out.
Hey, what's...
You know, stay back. What you doing here?
Look out.
Oh, my.
Come on, guys.
Oh, we got a new champ.
Wait a minute.
No, wait.
Wait, did that? Was that a 1-2-3?
The goblin.
It's the goblin gooker.
No.
Yes.
No.
Gobble, baby.
He's got the title.
He just.
Oh.
He just said gobble, baby.
When I catch you.
He fell flat on his beak.
When I catch you, I'm going to make you extra crispy.
What is happening?
One of his feet fell off.
Oh, my gosh.
What
did
we just witness?
He lost a
foot.
What do they call it?
What is that?
It's not a claw.
A claw?
Oh, my goodness.
How old is the gobbledygooker?
Everybody, we need to get like a minute 50. To decompress, really
Holy
absorb this. We're
going
to be
ago.
Right back.
Inspired by millions. Feel like a champion. And so much more. Find what fits you at WWEshop.com. This weekend only, Black Friday pricing on championship titles and buy one t-shirt, get one for $1.
Hello and welcome to Ringside here for the Survivor Series kickoff show. Tom Phillips alongside Samoa Joe and Byron Saxton. Byron, did I see that correctly? Is the gobbledygooker the 24-7 champion?
Yeah, see, the gobbledygooker is the 24-7 champion. And might I say, the gobbledygooker still has it, man. What a moment.
After 30 years, it's very impressive.
Some would say it was manifest destiny.
There's that. Samoa Joe, You know how big this night is, and we are set now for our first action of the night. We're about to find out who's the best of the best in this dual brand Survivor Series Battle Royal.
Oh, we're kicking it off the right way, Tom.
And plenty of superstars already filling the ring. And here comes one more, the legendary Rey Mysterio.
Making his way to the ring, Dominic Murphy and Rey Mysterio.
And Rey is not alone. The familia of the Mysterio family has grown as of this past Friday night on SmackDown, Byron, after Murphy's victory against Seth Rollins.
Yeah, I never thought I'd live the day to see the Mysterio family actually embrace Murphy.
Yeah, time has made interesting kinsmen, my friend, and the Mysterio family have seemed to taken on a new ward.
An opportunity here in this dual brand battle royal to set the tone for the evening here inside WWE Thunderdome. Well, Survivor Series is brought to you in part by Cricket Wireless. When awesome calls, you answer smile, you're on Cricket. And joining us live tonight from the WWE Thunderdome, some of Cricket's very own best of the best. Take a look, guys.
I like this. We're a good company here.
They got a great ringside seat for this first action here. And Joe, everywhere the Miz goes, it begs the question, could tonight be the night?
To the ring, Mr. Money in the Bank, The Miz!
Miz is a man who prides himself on making the right moves at the right time. And Tom, you never know when The Miz is going to strike, let's be honest.
The Money in the Bank contract gives The Miz a guaranteed WWE or Universal
and
title
John
opportunity.
Morrison!
And with John Morrison by his side, Miz can cash in the contract anytime, anywhere.
And you know, if Miz were somehow to come out victorious in this battle royal, we would never hear the end of that as well.
And considering the gigantic matchup we have tonight, the WWE Champion Drew McIntyre from Raw against the Universal Champion Roman Reigns from SmackDown, The Miz has a golden opportunity, perhaps.
Well, The Miz knows he's got all the power in his hands. We've seen him flex that power week after week. Understands he's a threat to whomever the champion is.
If Miz can come out unscathed, that is, from this battle royal, the rules are you must send your opponent over the top rope with both feet touching the floor. The last man standing is the winner. And here we go. Right off the bat, the first competition of the evening. As we're trying to find out, Joe, who's the best of the best. You've competed at this event. How special is this night?
Well, it's very special because it sets the tone going into the rest of the years. I mean, the best of the best.
Oh,
the brightest superstars from each brand that come out in cross combat, warfare. You know what happens, Tom? Do you know what happens? Tonight is when we prove, when we set the stage of who is the best of the best.
And Morrison is eliminated by Dominic.
That is huge.
Oh, the
Dominic.
Miz.
There goes Miz's insurance.
He's unhappy.
His insurance policy, at least in this match.
Miz might be on the verge of joining Morrison in a second.
And Dominic trying to get rid of Mr. Money in the Bank. Meanwhile, center of the ring, Luchador meets Luchador. Kalisto and Rey Mysterio.
This is the beauty of a battle royal.
Everybody look at that.
Whoa, and there goes Mysterio.
Nice.
Kalisto, who's taken to calling himself the greatest luchador of all time, the GOAT.
Oh! Meant by the Hurt Business.
Obviously, Rey Mysterio taking umbrage with that.
Yeah, has every right to. And it's Shelton Benjamin and Cedric Alexander, Joe, who have got to be in a fighting mood after their Raw Tag Team title bid this past week.
Oh, there's no doubt that the Hurt Business, they're definitely
starting. Kalisto's gone.
They're taking it out on Kalisto, Tom.
Yeah, Kalisto's been eliminated. We know, of course, as a result of the matchup, as I just mentioned with the Hurt Business, it's the New Day versus the Street Profits later tonight on the Survivor Series pay-per-view, champions versus champions. And Kalisto pretty ticked off here at ringside.
Understandably so, and I'm sure MVP has coached up Cedric Alexander, Shelton Benjamin to try to come out victorious here tonight, boost the stock of the Hurt Business on Raw.
Well, MVP's definitely going to be paying attention to Bobby Lashley versus Sami Zayn, United States champion versus Intercontinental champion tonight at Survivor Series. And look at Robert Roode with Mysterio.
Oh, look at Robert Roode. Oh, he's in a bad, bad position.
Oh. About to get ourselves a two-for-one special.
Oh, no, we're not. Super Kick Ziggler protecting his tag team partner, Roode.
Those plans change quickly.
A rough Friday night for Ziggler and Roode. Oh, but a little bit of atonement getting rid of Rey Mysterio. Here comes Murphy.
Look at Murphy.
Murphy, of course, the boyfriend of Aaliyah Mysterio.
Interestingly enough, Tom. I mean, quite a change of fortune since we last saw them.
Absolutely right. It's been quite some time.
And Murphy feels a little better not being hounded by the Monday Night Messiah the way he was
during his tenure on Raw.
And Shinsuke Nakamura.
Shinsuke struggled with Ricochet, but.
Oh, look at this. Carrillo and Angel Garza. Cousin versus cousin. Whoa. Oh.
Great balance by Carrillo.
These two Raw superstars, and Carrillo sent into the barricade. Both feet touch the floor. Carrillo's gone.
Brutal landing for Carrillo.
And now, those are the risks of doing.
Miz could be gone here in a matter of moments.
Yes, he could. And those are the risks of high-risk maneuvers in these type of matchups. It's a target-rich environment, and you're never safe.
The benefit of having your tag team partner in there paying dividends for Ziggler and Rude.
Angel Garza.
There he goes.
Over the top. There goes Garza.
Hurt Business on a roll here.
Solid venture for the Hurt Business. And you can see Apollo Crews in there going after Murphy. Shinsuke Nakamura's back outside the ropes against Chad Gable.
And the Hurt Business, I mean, they're open and they're serving everybody in that ring.
Gotta like Shinsuke Nakamura's chances in this style of matchup, Byron. He did win the Royal Rumble match. Very similar rule set.
Absolutely. There's a built-in confidence there for Shinsuke. This could boost his stock on Friday Night SmackDown to a whole new level.
Oh, and Ricochet, he's made a dire mistake.
Oh, now look at this. Dominic could get muscled out of the ring by the leader of the Alpha Academy, Chad Gable.
Dominic holding on for dear life.
Ricochet on the outside of the ropes, trying to fight off the familiar foes of the Hurt Business. Kick to the face of Murphy.
No.
Former friends here, Alexander and Ricochet.
How appropriate is this moment right here between Ricochet?
Look at the tightrope.
Ricochet trying to hang on. Oh, went for the super kick.
What is this?
Alexander's eliminated.
Yes, he is.
How good must that feel for Ricochet?
Devastating. Watch that knee.
Benjamin with a knee strike. Ricochet's gone, and now Apollo Crews eliminates Benjamin. Crews had plenty of issues with the Hurt Business on Raw.
And this is the chaos of a battle royal. You never know. When you think that you are on offense, you find out you're on defense, and then you're eliminated.
Got to have your head on a swivel, no question about it.
Joe, you're always good in these matches of duping somebody, convincing them they're your friend, and then eliminating them anyway.
Well, I've been doing it here for weeks, Tom. You're absolutely right.
What? But now Ziggler out on the apron, and Murphy. Murphy's on the edge. Both feet have to touch the floor to be eliminated.
Two very close calls for both Murphy and Ziggler.
Ziggler's got a lot of fond memories of the Survivor Series pay-per-view event. Been a survivor multiple times.
Survived this moment.
Kick to the back of the neck of Rude. Now Murphy.
Murphy fending off. And
Murphy taking out Rude again, backing up his partner. And there goes Rude. And now Ziggler looking for some vengeance on behalf of Rude.
Dominic Mysterio, I think it's surprising a lot of people.
Gable with a devastating kick to Elias.
Elias is down. Dominic and Ziggler along the apron. Difficult situation, and Joe, the herd is beginning to thin.
Oh, yes, we're getting down to what I like to call the nitty-gritty. And these boys, this fight's getting very, very ugly.
It's about to get uglier for Ziggler. Or Mysterio, I got a feeling.
A little over 15 minutes now until the Survivor Series pay-per-view event begins streaming live on the WWE Network. A very special night as we honor 30 years of The Undertaker. The Dead Man will be here live later tonight inside WWE Thunderdome for his final farewell.
I get goosebumps just thinking about it, Tom.
Well, Ziggler.
Ziggler. Ziggler could have gotten caught. And now it's Dominic with the drop kick.
How about the performance from Dominic Mysterio?
Ziggler is out of this match. And Byron, you're absolutely right. Joe, we saw this from Dominic in his time on Raw, how he can blossom as a competitor.
Well, he's definitely blossoming. And beyond that, if you would have told me Dominic Mysterio would still be involved in this match and his father wouldn't be, I would have called you crazy.
You're absolutely right. Now, look at this. Elias is going after Mr. Money in the Bank to Miz, who, despite losing John Morrison early on, Byron, Miz is still in here.
Yeah, Miz is still there, kind of. I'm not sure he's aware of where he is at the moment.
Taking some punishment from Cruz and Elias.
And temporary alliances pay dividends in this sort of environment.
Look at Chad Gable teeing off on Dominic Mysterio. Now Cruz turns his attention to the former United States Intercontinental and Tag Team Champion Shinsuke Nakamura.
This is not Nakamura. Where you want to be, Apollo.
Knee into the top turnbuckle.
And now, watch out, this might be that effortless power I've talked about.
240-pounder. Nakamura with the block. And Elias stopped in his tracks by Cruz, and there's a knee strike.
And I like that. Elias ran a little interference down low.
Oh!
So you and Nakamura know each other all too well, both former NXT champions.
And here's something about Nakamura you always need to remember. He is the consummate survivor. I mean, this event was named aptly just for him because he knows how to get in there and put himself in situations where he will survive.
And it appears inside the ring, we're down to six superstars. Jeff Hardy, who's been competing at Survivor Series since before the turn of the millennium. Oh, man, what a jawbreaker. The longevity of Hardy and eliminates Nakamura.
Numbers just dwindled down a little bit more.
It was an off night.
Yeah, a difficult night for Nakamura, but a great showing nonetheless in this dual brand battle royal.
You know about the disdain between Elias and Jeff Hardy. That continues week by week on Raw.
Elias still accuses Hardy of hitting him with a car this past summer on SmackDown, even though we know that's not true.
Oh, and up and over goes Elias.
Oh! Elias over the top rope, both feet much touch the floor. Now it's Hardy. Oh, great job by Hardy. And Elias, there will be no curtain call.
We are down to the final four.
I'll keep an eye on Gable.
Chad Gable looking for a career resurgence. This could be the night to do it. Jeff Hardy saw it coming. Everybody very wary, Joe, of Chad Gable.
And this is a very interesting situation.
And look at this, Joe, the veterans, Miz and Hardy, maybe talking about an alliance here against the relative newcomers in WWE.
Very interesting game plan. See if it pays off here.
Oh! And Gable's eliminated Jeff Hardy.
Down to three.
Oh, now Miz will set up for the skull-crushing finale. Dominic Mysterio set him up.
Oh, yes, he set him, and we're taking a trip down to San Diego.
Went for the 619, and Miz.
Wow.
I suffered that fate too many times and was ready for it.
Oof. That's when it seemed like the Miz was on the verge of elimination. Now it's the Miz who's standing tall.
And imagine if the Miz can set the tone tonight, not only for his brand. But for his own endeavors as the face of USA and also with the Money in the Bank contract in hand tonight inside WWE Thunderdome.
Everything could be in Miz's favor.
And now the it kicks to Dominic.
Laying in those kicks to the chest of Dominic.
And Miz trying to summon the WWE Universe, and down goes Dominic.
Feel the confidence growing for the Miz. The Miz must feel like he's got this thing won.
A critical time in this dual brand Survivor Series Battle Royal.
And the Miz just looking to dose out more punishment. Whoa, what's this?
Well, Miz took a little much too much time, and now it's Dominic trying to wear down Miz.
Here's a sense of urgency for Dominic.
But he's almost got him.
Trying to kick Miz off of the apron. Miz has gone over the top rope. Dominic's eliminated Miz.
Whoa, he got him.
Gable.
Oh, the officials, wait a minute. The officials were nodding their head about Miz. I don't know what happened there exactly. Dominic and Chad Gable tied up now.
Dominic on the move.
Great job by Gable to hang on.
Rolls through right back up.
Amateur wrestling credentials on display for Gable.
Oh, yes, they are.
And now,
the elevation.
Dominic is hurt. Chad Gable can be a suplex machine given the opportunity, and he's taking it to Dominic Mysterio. Now trying to hoist Dominic over the top rope and eliminate Dominic from this battle royal.
And this is the great variable of battle royals. Is even though you may beat a man up, you still need to get him over that top rope.
Big forearm shots by Gable. Saw what wonders the Alpha Academy did for Otis, who's a part of Team SmackDown on the men's side later on tonight. What a marquee win this would be for Gable.
Dominic. Look up below.
Oh, and Dominic, great job there on Gable.
Dominic gonna try this again.
And here we go.
Whoa!
No, he missed.
Went for the 619. Gable trying to hang on to Dominic here, center of the ring.
Oh, no.
Went to power through, and Dominic has had an answer.
This time,
619. A 619 by Dominic. And now can he eliminate Chad Gable?
Yes, he can.
Gable's been eliminated.
Incredible.
And Dominic, Dominic set up at the top. Miz was never eliminated. Miz wins.
Here's your winner, Mr. Money in the Bank, The Miz.
Guys, from earlier on that I was mentioning. Miz may have gone over the top rope, but he rolled back underneath the rope, the officials deeming that he was not actually eliminated. Watch right here. See that rolling right back inside the official. You could see waving it off. Not an official elimination for Dominic.
You got me and got Dominic Mysterio, who thought he won this whole battle royal.
And that is how The Miz was able to gain victory in this dual brand battle royal. So Joe, it begs the question, Miz setting the tone here with the Money in the Bank contract in hand. Could this be Miz's night?
Well, it very well could be, Tom. And I think a little bit later on tonight, it very well may be.
Could we see a cash-in at Survivor Series?
Weekend only. Black Friday pricing on championship titles and buy one t-shirt, get one for $1. Only at WWEshop.com.
Hey, Kevin. Man, it's real nice of you to show up. You could have showed up Friday night when you need your help against the New Day. Where were you? Do you need a red shirt or are you Team Blue? Our team is a flat-out mess. Who knows where Jay's head's at? You can't trust Otis. We all saw what happened to Seth Rollins on Friday night. So it's up to you and me. We have to carry this thing. So you know what? I've got some connections. If you're here, outside of here, I can get you opportunities. I can get you title shots. All you gotta do, out there, follow my lead.
So you just need me to follow your lead?
You follow my lead, we get this done. It's that simple.
Let me think about that.
All right.
Thought about it. Nope.
Mr. King Corbin, here is my headshot on the back resume. If you're looking to develop your personal skills, you can see here, I did study psychology at university. Ah. Okay. Yeah. All right, got it.
All right, King Corbin not looking for anything from Billy Kay, just like Kevin Owens not looking for anything from King Corbin. All right, we will see how that match pans out, the traditional five-on-five men's elimination Survivor Series match. But tonight we also will have a battle to determine who sits atop the WWE mountain. Universal Champion Roman Reigns taking on WWE Champion Drew McIntyre, who began his second title reign just 6 days ago.
Roman Reigns had better be ready for Survivor Series to decide who truly is the best of the best.
At Survivor Series, I will beat WWE's secondary champion, Randy Orton.
Roman Reigns, you're not going to be facing Randy Orton at Survivor Series. This Monday on Raw, Drew McIntyre, Randy Orton for the WWE Championship. I am going to win that match in a Survivor Series. It's going to be you and me.
It's a main event worthy of WrestleMania. Drew McIntyre challenges Randy Orton for the WWE title. Thinking about a claymore. Oh, and the Viper rolled out of the way.
Hold it right there, Orton. There will be no countouts, no disqualifications. This match we'll continue, and that is official.
Stipulation may be a gift now for the WWE Champion.
The title's mine! It'll never be yours again!
Oh, through the table!
It might be Claymore time. Beautiful power slap counter!
Drew McIntyre and Randy Orton pushing each other to the limit.
Going for the RKO.
Claymore! Drew McIntyre has taken back the WWE title.
What a gratifying moment for Drew McIntyre.
I am the man now, and I will prove it at Survivor Series.
told me, go out and win myself a title. I won the title. Not for you, for me.
I knew you could do it. Paul, not so much. I knew, I believed you could do it. Paul told me years ago, you are the right guy in the right place at the wrong time.
Please, underestimate me.
At Survivor Series, WWE Champion.
You see being the top guy around here as a right. I see it as an honor.
Versus Universal Champion.
This is my yard. This is my island. This is my WWE.
This match is as headlining and as marquee gets.
Woo!
Man. It's going to be a good one. Just for anyone who forgot, also, Drew McIntyre is responsible for throwing out Roman Reigns in that Royal Rumble match en route to winning the WWE title at WrestleMania. Just don't want anyone to forget that moment happened. Now, Roman Reigns, obviously, for the past several weeks, was anticipating facing Randy Orton. Change up at the very last second. Will this throw him off in any way, shape, or form? Booker.
This is the shucky ducky quack quack
moment. Oh, wow. I did not know that.
Okay, first and foremost. What is it?
Where is it?
Nah, this is a big moment for Drew McIntyre here tonight. Be that as it may, how he got the championship. If Randy Orton wasn't prepared, that's his own luck. Preparation is the only luck you're ever going to have in life. So I see this being a big night. And I do think that Drew can walk in and walk out champion tonight.
Yeah, okay. I think the fact that for Drew McIntyre, the big thing is he's on a tremendous high. After just winning the title from Randy Orton, it's going to be real tough to stop that momentum that he's got.
This is the greatest moment of Roman Reigns' career. I don't see it end tonight. This is Roman's time, in my opinion.
Very few times do you see two guys in the absolute peak of their career and both believe they're the ones that belong there by destiny.
Yep.
That's what you see right now. This is a true heavyweight matchup.
It's going to be good.
So who do you have winning? We have two for Drew McIntyre, one for Roman Reigns.
Roman Reigns. I'm going with Roman Reigns.
Okay, so we've got two in two, ladies and gentlemen. I won't even throw my opinion because, look, these guys did all the work for me. And now let's go backstage to just – get a little peek at what's going on with the Raw men's team. The self-proclaimed Captain AJ Styles giving some instructions out to his team. Ladies and gentlemen, Survivor Series coming your way to determine the best of the best. Enjoy.